What's up YouTube, it's Bibini here, and today we shall see how can you transfer money from your account to other account. Now you know there are several methods like NEFT, IMPS, RTFT. Now which one to follow, which one is the convenient method for you to do that? Today we shall discuss that and we shall see which one will be convenient for you. Now for that I'm using SBI Anywhere app. You can use your own app, like if you have an Axis Bank account, you can use Axis Bank internet banking or even your Axis Bank apps, right? So the reason why I'm using SBI is it has all these features integrated right under one roof. So I'm gonna show you all the methods and I'm gonna tell you which one will be convenient for you. So let's begin. So I'm gonna log into my SBI account. Okay, so as you see there is a fund transfer. I'll go to fund transfer, and so here are the things. There are several methods, there are several sections, right? So understand that to send money to through these sections up to IMPS, you need to have a beneficiary account added already. So what is a beneficiary account? It's a details of account, like if you're sending it to a friend, you need to add the friend account number, IFFC code, bank branch and stuff like that. You can add that just by checking this. You need to enter your password also. Okay. So once you logged in through your profile password, so you need to type a beneficiary type, like if it's within SBI or within its other bank, let's say other bank. So as you can see, I already have several beneficiary added. So if I want to add another one, you can go here and see, as you can see, you need to add name, IFFC code, account number, address, and transfer limit and stuff like that. Although address and all is not mandatory, so you need to enter all the account number, IFFC code. It's a big deal, right? So you use beneficiary only when you transfer amount to the person very frequently, like once in 2 months, once in a week or something. So you don't need to enter the account number again and again, right? So make sure to access all these four, you need to have a beneficiary account. So let's assume I've added a beneficiary account. So I've not added a beneficiary account. So if I go to this, as you can see, it says I don't have any registered beneficiary within SBI. So I don't have any SBI friends so that I can, you know, have added my beneficiary, right? So I have other bank account. If I go to this, you can see this is my account number, and you see three modes of transfer: IMPS, NEFT and RTGS. Now the IMPS is immediate mobile payment system, right? So the payment will be done immediately, and yeah, as you can see, the beneficiary that I added there, that I've added before, it appears here. So just select one and then make sure you click here for transaction limits and charges to know what are the charges that are there, so you will get every detail here. So for different modes of transfer, for different amounts, there are different charges. So make sure you know that before sending money to anyone, right? So now IMPS is the receiver will get the money immediately. Now NEFT is kind of a batch processing system, right? It only works between in the daytime. I guess the timing is around 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. So if you are doing it after that, the transaction will be processed tomorrow after 8 a.m. So that's how it is, NEFT. And I don't prefer you to use NEFT. And RTGS is for transaction more than like 2 lakhs together of money, so which obviously I don't have it right now in my account, so I'm not gonna, I can't do that, right? So these are the transfer that you have in other bank's account. Now IMPS, as I said, IMPS, it's an immediate mobile payment system. So it's the same thing which was there has been added here also. So if you have IMPS, this is my IMPS number, so it goes something like 6 or 7 digit, I suppose. So if you have that MMID, which will be given once you activate IMPSC. So let's say a friend of mine has an IMPS activated and he has MMID and he has given me the MMID, I don't need to enter his account number, IFFC code, nothing is needed. only its mobile number and its beneficiary MMID, that is its MMID, right? So that is needed. To activate IMPS, you can just surf online, or I'll put the links in the description below so that you can find out how you can activate IMPS with your respective banks. Okay, this is IMPS. And yeah, quick transfer. So this is where you can transfer money to anyone without adding beneficiary. So as I said before, you can add beneficiary through the add beneficiary option that is there in the app. So in the same way, you can add you don't need to add beneficiary account for this. So you don't need to wait until the beneficiary account is activated, right? So you can directly go here and you can add account number. Let's say our name is Bibini. Okay, and account number something like 9999999999. Obviously it's not a right account number, so I'm just giving an example. Now again, you need IFFC code. You know IFFC code, SBI IFFC code starts with SBIN003, something like that. So you need to add IFFC code also, and then amount to be transferred, and if you have any remarks. So if you click send, the amount will be sent. So this is a quick transfer, so it can be done within State Bank or even something non-SBI, that is non-State Bank account also. There is no problem, the account will be, the money will be transferred right away. But there are some limits, so make sure you read this for every section. You read the click here for transaction limits and charges, so that you will know what are the limits and also what are the charges that are there with the respective methods, right? Okay, now there is one more called send mcash, and this is I know this is only for State Bank. They call it mcash. So through this, what you can do is you can, instead of giving the account number, you can directly send a link to, you know, for the receiver, so that he can use that link to receive the money. So if you enter your friend's number here, and if you have entered like $1,000 and if you have sent it, so the receiver, your friend will receive a message or an email, whichever your choice, with a link which can be used further by the receiver to receive the money. So if you have sent like $1,000, so you'll get a link saying your friend has sent you $1,000. So you'll click on the link. Now after clicking on the link, he has to enter his account number, his IFFC code, all those stuff, mobile number and all. So once he has done that, is the amount that you have sent, that is how you said give him $1,000. So his $1,000 will be immediately transferred to his account. So that's how this works. And this is, I don't know if this is quite useful, but yeah, you have all these things in SBI. You know, they have the different modes, and you can see it right there. The service tax is much. The service tax is like 2.5 per request, right? So you can use this also, but I don't prefer the using that. And yeah, I guess that's it. And scheduled transaction, obviously you can see if there are any scheduled transactions. So scheduled transaction, usually it comes with NEFT. So you can say, okay, send $1,000 to a friend X at tomorrow 2 p.m. right? So you can schedule that using a net banking. I think it's available right here also, so that you can see if it's successful. If it's still not in process, you can see all those scheduled transactions right there. So concluding all this, which method will I prefer? If you're familiar with your friend, if you're familiar with the receiver, so obviously you will have his account number, IFFC code and all, so you can go to quick transfer. So if you're using the receivers again and again, so if you have to pay him again and again, like weekly once or monthly once or something like that, I prefer you adding his beneficiary account. Like you can go and add his beneficiary name and account, so that every time you need not enter his mobile number and stuff like that. So if you want someone whom you don't trust that much, like you don't want to give your reveal your account number or IFFC details, so in that case you can activate IMPS and send him just the 7-8 digit number, that is MMID number, so that you won't even give a single damn thing about your account, not even your account number, not even your IFFC code, not even your bank branch, nothing, only a 7-8 digit IMPS number. So as I use every day, I prefer IMPS, or rather I pretty much IMPS all the time, because all you need is mobile number and MMID and not a bit about your account details, not even your account number for that matter, right? So I would prefer activating IMPS and then transferring money through that. And I guess that's it. And this was a small video. I didn't need to dive into each and every section and tell you the difference between this and this. I just briefed out on the on the top. So if you need to know about depth, if you need to know about each and everything, please use the comment section below. And even if you have any doubts, make sure you ask it in the comment section below, and I'll reply as soon as possible. And along with this, if you're interested in photography, please do check my Instagram page. You can find the link in the description below, the same link, instagram.com/pibini. I hope you like it, and until next time, bye bye.